Hello everyone, my name is Manashree and now I'm going to deal with the topic e-learning. As we all know that this is an era of technology. As time goes on, one or more technologies are replaced by other. And old telephones are replaced by small mobile. iPads, tabs have filled the places of books. Where we would go search books in the library, but now we have a digital library where we can access any quick information. So in this development of technology, e-learning is major one. Let's get into the introduction. So the letter E in the e-learning stands for the word electronic. So it is stated as electronic learning. So when we hear the term electronic learning, we obviously get the thoughts computer, lappies, iPads, etc. Exactly. So the learning which is done through an electronic device, it is called as e-learning. So it was first installed by the Bernard Leskin in 1963, where he introduces the e-learning in the college community. He is the pioneer. Further, he states that e-learning, where E stands for exciting, energetic, enthusiastic, emotional, extended, and educational. So it is a storehouse of education, information, communication, training, knowledge, and performance management. Let's see the definitions of e-learning. Darren E. Hartley, he says that teaching and learning process by using internet media, intranet, or other computer network in order to give the material to the students. According to him, a learning process which is taking place through internet media, intranet, or any other computer network where the children are being educated and where the children are learning. This is an e-learning, according to him. According to Matt Comercaro, e-learning, where it is a means of education, and it incorporates self-motivation, communication, efficiency, and technology. According to Derek Stockley, the delivery of learning, training, or education program by electronic means. So here the electronic devices include computer or mobile phone, where the training and education is provided to the students. And according to LSDA, e-learning is a learning that is supported or enhanced through application of information and communications technology. Getting into the futures, e-learning is dynamic, like it is a power. Today in the era of globalization, it helps in availing the online experts best sources and quick approaches just in a single mouse click. We can get anything like best online advisors, like any quick approaches just in a single mouse click. Second one, e-learning is individual, that is centered across the learner and personalized to the individual. It's like an personal or individual learning process where it is unlike the classrooms. Next, e-learning operates in real time, that is available for 24 hours and 7 days. Once we access the internet, so we can work through it 24 hours a day and all 7 days a week. It's just like a lifelong learning process. Next one, e-learning is comprehensive, where every information are connected and every information we can access. Next, it is network assisted and often learning is done within a fraction of time. So if we are interested in anything, we don't have to depend on any experts or anything. We don't have to wait for anything. Just we can search or anything and learn anything in a fraction of seconds. Next, blend of learning methods such as virtual classroom, simulation, community, and even a classroom. Here it provides the atmosphere of a classroom. Like we have online classes from morning till morning 10 to evening 4. where we interact with the teachers, so a virtual classroom environment is provided through e-learning. There are mainly two types in e-learning. First one, synchronous. Second one, asynchronous. Here, synchronous is which is going together. Like sync means which is getting together or which is matching. Andra yeradu sambandhadava. Asynchronous is which is not related. Yeradu sambandh vandukon sambandh irlardak asynchronous antar. Coming to the definitions, synchronous e-learning. Synchronous learning. Here, learning and teaching is taking place in the same time, where trainers and learners are physically separated. See, online teaching is where obviously physical separation is there, but learners and teachers are being online, and interaction, like two-way interaction, we can say it. Two-way interaction is going on, and the questions and anything can be discussed in the same time without a time delay. Examples: listening to a live radio broadcast, watching live television broadcast, audio video conference, internet telephony, online lecturers as we have, etc. Asynchronous e-learning. Asynchronous e-learning is the fact that the trainer prepares the courseware material before the course takes place. The learner is free to decide whether he wants to study the courseware or no. See, this is the thing where the lecturers will make the videotaped classes or audio taped classes and send it to the students, where they download it and they can learn it or hear it whenever they want. Like, there is no time schedules, like as we have in the online classes. Like, we have to come at 10 and go at 4. It is not such. So the students is free to decide when he wants to study the courseware. In other words, asynchronous e-learning, where people are not online. See, here the interaction is not taking place at the same time. It doesn't occur. Like, there is no participation of the students. There is no time schedules. Okay. Examples include videotaped classes, stored audio or video web presentations or seminars, recorded audio tapes, question and answer mentoring, reading email messages, etc. So, everything has its own advantages and disadvantages, right? It totally depends on us, like how we take it and how we use it. So, what are the advantages of e-learning? First one, it is very efficient way of delivering online courses, like as we all know. It is the quick process where any online experts, they'll be sitting anywhere and will be sitting anywhere. Like, we can get connected each other. Next one, due to its convenience and flexibility, the resources are available from anywhere at any time, as I said now. Third one, as you have to access net 24/7, you can train yourself anytime from anywhere. Like, if we just have a net, and if we like, we can work 24/7 and just train yourself. Fourth one, it is a very convenient and flexible option above all. You don't have to depend on anyone for anything. Okay, like, it's one of the convenient option. Like, from rest of all the things, we can just easily access through the net, and like, we can do what we want, like in learning. Next, fifth, unlike classroom teaching, with online learning, you can access the content an unlimited number of times. See, it is not like classrooms where teaching is limited. Like, once we can say teacher to repeat or twice, we can say, but not more than that, okay? But here it's not such. We can see the recordings, or we can get into the online anytime and see unlimited number of, and watch unlimited number of times what we want until we reach it. Sixth one, saves time and money. At the same time, it is environment friendly. See, it is a paperless method of learning, where we need not need any books or textbooks, like anything. So it even saves the time, like transportation, going and coming, like it saves the time and even money also. Seventh one, provides a platform where participants can communicate with each other or with trainers and experts. See, it's like as I already said, it provides the classroom atmosphere where the learners or instructors can communicate and interact with each other. Coming to the disadvantages, first one, learners need to have access to a computer as well as the internet. Okay, some people may afford to computer or some people may not. So the learners should have computer or any electronic devices, and internet is like obviously it is compulsory. Next one, learners also need to have computer skills with programs such as word processing, internet browsers and email. Like a least knowledge of technology the learner should acquire. Next one, e-learning also requires just as much as time for attending classes and completing assignments as any traditional classroom course. See, we have enough online classes, we have 1 hour, like one class is for 1 hour. Even in colleges, we attend one class for 1 hour. So there is no difference. So they say that there is not much time difference for attending classes or attending the online classes. There is no much difference. And next one, students may feel isolated from the instructor. Like we may feel like as we are feeling now in online classes, we may feel that far from lecturers and even far from our friends too. Slow or unreliable internet connections can be frustrating. Yeah, this is the major one. So the students who are in rural areas, like they may face network issues a lot. So when the student is very interested in learning, if he is facing the network issues, that like it's a hell frustrating kind. So that's a disadvantage. Next, teachers' lack of knowledge and experience to manage virtual teacher-student interaction. Yeah, some teachers, like they may lack the knowledge of technology, and they may fail in handling this virtual classroom, like false classroom, and they may lack the knowledge, and there may be a problem. Okay, next one, lack of direct and immediate feedback from teachers. As there is no face to face interactions with teachers and students, so teacher may they may lack the direct and immediate response to the students. Next one, asynchronous communication hinders fast exchange of question. Yeah, as we already know what is asynchronous learning, so there is no online communication, so it may hinder the exchange of question. Okay, next one, danger of procrastination, that is to postpone or delay needlessly. The students, when it is online classes, like some students may also neglect the classes, and they may they may neglect it. So these were the disadvantages. Now coming to the end, that is conclusion. So here, e-learning, its intention is not to replace the conventional methods of learning. Like it does not want to replace the real classrooms, but its aim is to just create an learning environment where technology is used to deliver a combined range of teaching and learning techniques, where maximum students can participate, and it reaches to the corner of the students so that the students can achieve their goals and in the learning and teaching process, so further they can be successful. Thank you.